You're studying computer science. You know how to upgrade his smartphone. So my mum has made a few friends while being pregnant with me, and so most of my friends are my age. One of these friends got a little brother, EK, who has something like Asperger. Until his birth, the mother was fine, and I spent a bunch of summer over at my friend's. Around 10 years, this changed. My friend's mother went from nice mum to entitled mum, in a record-breaking time of just 1 week. And by this, I really mean from one extreme to the other. I knew her my whole life, and she was very kind and had always had ice cream. Every time I was at my friend's house, she picked on both of us until we left, because we interrupt her little prince's sleep. We just watched some Laurel and Hardy. It's a silent film, for crying out loud. So we started to spend more time over at my place. It was last summer when our story played. I just got accepted at a university to start my studying on computer science. Since my mother is very close to EM, she knew about it. That evening, we had a little party because my dad turned 50, and of course, EM and EK were invited too. Note that EK was around 9 years old. The dialogue went something like this. So I'm sitting at the grown-ups table, messaging my girlfriend from time to time, but the entitled kid sees me unlocking my smartphone with the fingerprint. Hey, how'd you do this? Oh, my smartphone recognized my thumb. Wow, that's cool. Does it recognize mine as well? No, it only knows my fingers. But I want to unlock your smartphone with my thumb too. Sorry, but I usually don't let other people use my phone. But I want to! The entitled kid took off, and I hoped this would be it, even though deep down I knew it wasn't. And otherwise, I wouldn't tell you this story. Around 5 minutes later, the entitled kid came back with the entitled mother. My son told me you wouldn't let him use your phone? I wouldn't let the kid save his fingers in my smartphone. This way he can log in every time, and I don't have any slots free for him. On my phone, you can only save like 4 fingerprints, and these were the thumbs of my girlfriend and mine. Aw, oh, that's rubbish. You know EK so long. You can trust him. Knowing that I can't trust him. Yeah, but I still got only 4 slots, and these are already filled. That's such a lame excuse. But can you set this up on EK's phone? Sure, why not? I was surprised that a 9-year-old had already had a smartphone, but whatever. It was EM's little prince. The entitled kid gave me his phone. I checked the setting to find out that his phone wasn't that new, and it hadn't had a fingerprint sensor in the home button. Oh, I'm sorry, it seems that your phone doesn't support fingerprints. He started losing his first tears. What? Why? But I'm sure you can do something. Apparently, Samsung didn't build this into his phone. Yeah, but yours has it. I bought mine half a year ago. This must be like 2 years old. I know you start computer science. There must be a way you can fix this. No, the only thing you can do is buy him a new phone. I can support you with this if you wish. Now she started to get a bit more aggressive. No thanks, it would be enough if you do it on this phone. You could remove your fingerprint sensor and build it into EK's phone. Now I was surprised by this lack of understanding. That's not how this works. The kid is crying the whole time. Mommy, I want this. Do you hear him? He deserves it. Make it work. Yeah, he's pretty annoying. And excuse me, I have to leave now. After this, I left for my girlfriend's without a comment. The next day, I told my dad about this, and since he has a great understanding of how this works, we had a great laugh about it. I know that everyone working in this field has at least one similar story. You know, I'm surprised the entitled mother didn't steal the actual fingerprint phone from the guy. Maybe they're getting better. They're changing their actions. Probably not. Entitled parent wants me banned from family gathering because I refuse to let his son hit me with a bat. So, my uncle recently got remarried, so that reminded me of an incident that happened with his son when he was very young. Now, I used to have a very decent relationship with my uncle. He was the youngest of my dad's siblings, and born almost 15 years after my dad, he was always kind of a wild child, but when he had a son, he really settled down. For the proceed of the story, my uncle would be EU, my cousin as EB, and I'm, of course, me. So during the summer, we all head over to my aunt's farm, during the summer. This year, Spider-Man 3, the Tobey Maguire one, had just come out. Now, I was still pretty young, about 13 at the time. EB was about 8, being quite a bit younger than me. Now, I was a late bloomer and had just hit the wave of puberty where girls sprout up like weeds. We were talking about Spider-Man and how it was his favorite movie. I liked it too, so I tried to talk to him about it. He got upset and said girls couldn't like Spider-Man. EB says I've probably never seen it, so I just roll my eyes and describe the plot to him. And he gets really mad. But for now, he simmers. Later, EB asks me to come outside and push him on the swing, and I do. Once again, I'm much bigger than him, so I can push him pretty high. Now, it was apparently his plan to show me that he was a boy and much stronger than me, so when he offered to push me on the swing, I accepted. He wasn't strong enough to get me very far, and this enraged him. I tried to explain to him, because I'm so much bigger than him, I weigh a lot more, but EB was having none of it. He rods off into my aunt's garage and comes back with a wood baseball bat. I'm so shocked, the first swing hits me clean in the stomach. The second was not too lucky. I'm bigger than him, and angry because I just coughed up half the orange pop I've been drinking before. I grab that bat, wrenching it from his hand. I tell him, never hit me again. And apparently, I'm so scary in that moment that he runs inside and gets his dad. Entitled Uncle storms out and the following occurs. What did you do to my son? He hit me. Why is he crying? Because I didn't let him. And why not? He was just playing. He hit me with a bat. Not long after that, the rest of my family came down. My dad and uncle talked, and we just went about the rest of the night, normally, except I was told I had to stay by my mum. During the half hour drive back to our home, my dad was angry and told me my uncle tried to have me not just sent home, which meant the whole family would have to leave, but he wanted me banned from family gatherings from there on. The fact my cousin admitted to everyone exactly what happened, as he saw nothing wrong with his actions, saved me from a lot of trouble. Naturally, I wasn't, but my uncle was always super wary of me whenever I was around them from now on. You know, after reading that, I reckon there should be an r/entitledkids subreddit because he was a brat. Entitled Mother tells me to move and stop hoarding the sun? I honestly wish I was making this up. I was hoping to never have to post on this subreddit, only read the stories. But here's a little background. As I type this, I am enjoying my last day with my grandparents in Florida while on spring break. I am from the north. I am so pale. I match the sand at the beach. Yesterday, I went with my grandparents to the beach. And our story begins as I decided that today, I'll go to the beach myself. The beach wasn't busy, but it wasn't exactly empty either. The beach was quite popular due to it having free parking, so I set my chair and cooler down, set up the chair, sit down, and began scrolling Reddit. About 10 to 15 minutes go by, and I feel someone standing over me and then tap on my shoulder. I turn around. Time to meet the cast. EM equals entitled mum, me equals me, and LH equals lady's husband. And so we begin. Can I help you?
Yes, I was wondering if I could ask you to move so that we can sit here.
I'm sorry, but I was here first and I would rather not. There are plenty of other good spots on the beach though.
But I need this spot.
Why this specific spot?
Because it's close to the exit, and I don't want to make my kids walk too far in the sand. Also, because this is where most of the sun is.
I look at her kids, a boy and his sister. They look maybe 12 to 13. Both look like they just want to go play in the water already. Your kids look fine. Why can't they just handle a little walk?
Just give me the spot.
Ma'am, I'm gonna be honest with you. I was here first. I'm just relaxing and minding my own business. Also, there is almost an equal amount of sun this far down the beach. You can find another spot.
Stop hoarding the beach in the sun. This is a public beach and you don't own it or the sun. Move now so me and my family can sit here.
Neither do you, which means I don't have to move. There's plenty of beach and more than enough sun for everyone.
Do you know who I am?
No, and I honestly don't care. At this point, the lady's husband walks up to us. Is everything okay here?
This little brat won't move and give us a spot. He is hoarding the beach and the sun for himself.
The lady's husband proceeds to look at his wife with a face that says, wow, I married this. Honey, the kids and I have already set up the tent over here. He points to a white tent with a chair set up under it. The kids are now in the water playing with the waves.
Why would you do that?
Because it was an open spot.
No, I wanted this spot. Move it all over here.
The lady's husband, trying to remain calm. Dude needs a medal after this. Look, you could have been relaxing and spending time with our kids for about as long as you have been screaming at this man who's minding his own business and enjoying the beach like everyone else here. Instead, you have been over here, acting like a child and making a scene. Entitled mother, and I am in shock. The only time I agree with EM this whole interaction. EM then stomps off towards the tent, and the lady's husband apologizes to me. They've been staying with his parents. EM and LH's mum tend to argue a lot, so it put EM in a bad mood. As a peace offering, LH gave me a Pepsi from the cooler, and we both went back to relaxing at the beach. Well guys, that's the end of the video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Maybe even share this video to one of your friends or family members. It would be greatly appreciated if you could. Just want to say down below in the description, I've got my merch links and my social media, so it'd be cool if you could check those out. Maybe even follow me over there. And I've also got my Patreon where you can get rewards for supporting me. The link is www.patreon.com/geofilms. So check that out. All the links down in the description. Hopefully you enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys later.